Hi guys, Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive. On the test bench today, we're taking a look at the TriplePlay Connect by Fishman. It is essentially a MIDI controller that attaches to any guitar and connects to both a proprietary iPad app and or any device that accepts MIDI via USB, which includes any pro or even consumer level DAW and a whole lot of hardware synths as well, if that's the sort of thing you're into. It works with any guitar, and to prove this, we have dug out a long-suffering Hagstrom Ultra Swede, which is currently lacking a set of pickups. Now, this is the guitar that we normally install pickups in when we're doing pickup demos, but it just happens to be lacking a pair now, and I thought we'd use this one to show you that none of the sounds you're hearing today are coming from this guitar, and they are all coming from the Fishman. It's essentially this little two-piece unit here, which is essentially a control and kind of interface, like an output device, which connects via this small cable to whatever you're plugging it into, be that an iPad or a Mac or whatever. And there's also this under-saddle pickup here, which is essentially a proprietary hexaphonic pickup. What that means, hex meaning six, is that there's one pickup for every string. You install this under your strings, you get it to just the right height, and it should, in theory at least, track perfectly, and also it should be able to sense what notes are being played on which string. For example, it knows the difference between an F played here at the 13th fret on the low E string versus an F played here on the 3rd fret of the D string. Now, this is rather interesting because it allows us via the Fishman app to essentially divide the fretboard into different zones that can do different jobs. Let's take a look at the screen recording we're taking right now. If you take a look at that kind of purpley pinky colored region of this fretboard, this is essentially the area of the fretboard that I currently have assigned to play the synth sounds that we have on the go here. So if I play up here above the 12th fret, we're going to get nothing at all. But as soon as I get to that 12th fret, my synth sounds start happening. Now, you'll also notice this set of play buttons with a number of green icons kind of stacked high above them. These are loops that we're able to trigger by playing different frets, and then they're tucked handily up here away from the playing area that I've assigned. Now, of course, you could expand that purple playing area to cover the entire fretboard or just a small portion, and you can actually expand it from the bottom up as well. So if you wanted to just play, for example, between the 9th and 12th frets, you could do that. Don't know why you would, but you could. But we can also play these loops by playing on the low E string, which triggers these loops in real time. So for argument's sake, if we play the 16th fret, we get this. And to stop a loop, it's as simple as playing the fret that you've assigned it to again. Now, you couldn't do this with a typical pitch to MIDI conversion because it would essentially associate this D string 3rd fret note with this E string 13th fret note, because it's the same pitch. But because we have an individual pickup for every string, we're able to assign different strings to different sounds and different functions, which is very clever. I should also point out that the loops that you play in the Fishman app don't have to be drum loops. In actual fact, they can be all manner of things. We have some things set up here, such as, I'll just activate them with my finger, some synth bells. And we have some plucks. And you can also import any audio files, either that you've recorded yourself or anything that happens to be in your iTunes library. You can drag those in and use those as loops, which you can trigger yourself. Now, let's get a little bit deeper into the sounds that we're using here. For this, I'm just going to disable the audio clips, and that means that my loops aren't going to trigger away. So we have two sounds available right now. We've selected a transpad over here on the left in red and a synth pluck over here in yellow. And we can actually determine determine the balance between these two by sliding the volume up and down, or we can turn them on and off like that. So if we just wanted sound two, we can get this. And what you'll notice with that is our sound two is actually an arpeggiator, so it's interpreting our chords and playing arpeggios based upon that, whereas sound number one is a polyphonic synth, which will give us this. And if we pop them both in and play some chords, we'll get an arpeggiator along with our pad, which gives us this. Which is very cool indeed. And of course you can actually change the sounds that you're using the buttons on the TriplePlay Connect. So there are two buttons up here. So for example, we could go from trance pad to, we have an ET pad. Let's find one that sounds interesting. Electro pad might be good fun. Let's have a listen to that on its own. Now we also have a fully featured effects section for each of these sounds. So for argument's sake, if we took our electro pad, we currently have a reverb and an analog delay. Let's maybe throw a phaser in there as well. And let's take out all of the dry signal on the reverb so it's 100% wet, which would give us this. Along with our arpeggiator, we'll get this. The other cool thing with this is that your loops and the arpeggiator will also map to the tempo of your project. So if for argument's sake we increase it from 70 BPM to 100 BPM, we'll get this. And that's also true of the loops, so if we throw those in, we can get something like this. Which is really rather cool. Now, we're not limited to just playing synth sounds. There are a bunch of kind of, if you want to call them, emulations of real instruments. Let's take something a little bit more conservative. Let's load a piano into sound number one. You'll notice I've turned off sound number two down here, and I've also turned off the audio clips. For this, I'm now going to enable the entire fretboard by opening up that purple playing area. So now I can play anywhere on the fretboard. If we take a piano, let's take, for argument's sake, the ugly piano, which sounds kind of interesting. Let's see how that behaves. Yep, it's definitely ugly, but it sounds pretty cool. Let's try the grand piano, and let's see if that's a bit more traditionally pretty. And for this, let's maybe open up the effects. Or maybe try a little bit more reverb than you might expect from a stock sound. I don't know, to be honest, I haven't listened to this yet, but we'll see. So you can hear how dynamic and responsive that is. It's really rather impressive. It allows you to play very expressively through this pretty sounding piano. Now, it should be noted that your technique has to be pretty clean to make this work. And if there are any slips and slops that you typically get away with an electric guitar sound, it might be interpreted by the Fishman app as a note that you intended to play. And there was one notable blip right in the middle of that, but we're gonna leave that be. So let's explore some more traditional type sounds. Let's have a look at some strings. Let's try ensemble strings. And once again, we're gonna take a listen to it, but I may throw a little more reverb on there. Yeah, let's make that a little more cinematic by increasing the reverb. We'll also increase the size of the room to make it absolutely massive. That sounds pretty fantastic, but let's throw some more effects on there. Let's have another phaser, and let's also have a modulated delay for argument's sake. And let's maybe back the reverb down a little bit now, because we've got all these other effects on, and let's see how this sounds. I think that sounds really rather cool. Now, there are a bunch of kind of other traditional instruments in here. There's drums. I'm not gonna try and play drums and guitar for you, but it might be a lot of fun. Let's try, for argument's sake, a nylon guitar. Now, this is interesting because this is gonna enable us to play some more traditional guitar style playing techniques like bends and slides. Let's explore that now. And as previously mentioned, this is actually going to enable us to play some more typical guitar style portamento things. Bends will work. Whereas if we try that same thing on something like, for argument's sake, a clav, it would trigger each individual pitch within the bend as its own discrete pitch like this. Which is a little awkward, but you wouldn't expect to be able to bend pitch on a clav anyway. So you really have to get yourself into the mindset of the instrument that you're playing, but that's actually really quite a cool thing because it sort of forces your hand creatively and it forces you to kind of think how the other half might think. Now, there are some combinations of sounds that we can use. Up until now, we've been layering sounds. So if, for example, we wanted to layer, let's take a very typical set. Let's take some strings. Let's take slow strings and let's take a piano. Why not? Because this gets used all of the time. We'll enable sound two. We can get this sort of business. But we don't have to have these two sounds playing at the same time. We can actually map them to different areas of the fretboard. So for argument's sake, let's choose one out of our menu of combis down here. I'm gonna go with one I looked at before we started rolling, which is GS hybrid and bass. Let's load that up now. Now, what you'll notice is we now have kind of a red area of the fretboard, and we also have a yellow area, the yellow area encompassing the low two strings. And these correspond to our red and yellow sounds. So sound one is currently our GS1 hybrid, which is a synth, sounds like this. And sound two is an electric bass, which is down here. There's a bunch of basses to choose from, one electric bass three. It gives us this sort of thing. Thank you. which essentially enables you to comp for yourself because you can play these two things independently. So you could have something like this. And immediately we have the soundtrack for a 90s sitcom, which is great fun. Now, of course, we're not limited to these two instruments. We could stack just about anything in here. So for argument's sake, let's maybe try some vibes. Why not? Let's try some vibes up there. And let's try in the bass category. We'll maybe not have an electric bass. Let's maybe have something, battery's about to die there. Let's maybe have something a little bit different. Perhaps in the string category, why not? Do we have... Nope, we don't have an upright bass, but you can buy one of those in the store. Let's maybe stick with an electric bass. Let's maybe have electric bass 1, because it's green. Why not? We'll just let that load. And now we're going to get this sort of thing. So as you can see, you can layer just about any instrument that you want, and it's not just limited to the ones that are stock in the app. You can also buy them in the store. There's going to be a whole bunch of other instruments that you can pick from, which is really cool indeed. There are some other effects you can play with. You can play with some of the parameters of these instruments, such as the EQ. You can transpose them. You can also use the arpeggiator. You can use auto chords and stuff. We're not going to get into that today, but it's good fun. Of course, there's effects on each as well. You can also use the TriplePlay as a MIDI controller on any guitar into any device that accepts MIDI over USB. So for example, if you were recording into, say, Logic, you could just plug this in and play any of the software instruments that are in Logic, which is really cool. Or if you have a hardware synth that accepts a USB MIDI input, you can use it to trigger hardware live, which is super cool. Now, I did say it works on any guitar. I didn't talk too much about the installation process because we've actually filmed that for you. So what we're gonna do is go back in time. We're gonna take a look at getting this pickup onto this guitar. Let's take a look at that now. Okay, so we have laid out in front of us all of the parts that are necessary for installing your TriplePlay Connect. First of all, obviously there is the aforementioned pickup down here. These guys are essentially for mounting this kind of controller part of the pickup to your guitar's body. We're gonna mount it to the end pin today, but you can stick that straight to the front of your guitar if you so desire. We've also got a mounting plate for a tunematic bridge that we're gonna use, and then these four shims that all have sticky 3M kind of, sticky stuff on the back, for which you're gonna use those to attach the actual pickup. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna set ourselves a timer, or rather a stopwatch on my phone. I'll keep that in shot so you can see exactly how long it takes, or doesn't, to install the TriplePlay. Let's get the timer rolling and get stuck in. Okay, so we've slacked our strings, everything is in place, we're ready to go. We've got the timer all set up. Let's see how quickly we can do this. So, first step is sliding this tunematic bridge out. And what we're gonna do there is we're gonna stick this guy, which is the bridge plate. It's a mounting plate we're gonna use for our pickup. And we're gonna slide that on top of our posts, which is right here. And then the tunematic bridge is gonna go back on top. Now really, you should take your strings off while you're doing this, but I'm being a little lazy for the sake of what we're doing today, and I also don't want to sit and restring a guitar on camera for you, and that is a lovely flush fit against our humbucker mount. Now that's going to be just perfect for getting our pickup installed, and it's also going to allow us to sync the action to the height that we had it before we stuck this mounting plate on. Anyway, the next step, we're going to take our actual pickup itself, and we're going to use one of these mounting shims. Now, the shims themselves are essentially, they've got sticky stuff on the bottom from 3M, who make dual lock, hence the confusion. We're going to slide this guy onto the very base of our pickup, and it just clicks into place, which is very clever. It goes in that way, and that forms a really secure mount. I'm gonna find the one that puts us at the perfect height. Now, conveniently, Fishman have included this little tool right here, which is actually shaped like a guitar, which is very cute. And what that's got is it's got kind of a little lip on the end of it, and that is to essentially set the height between your string and the pickup itself. Now, there is some fine adjustability available, but it's probably best to find the right shim for this first of all. And because we're doing a tunamatic bridge, the actual mounting plate itself is going to move up and down with the bridge when we adjust our action. So when we get it right, it's going to stay right regardless of where we set our string height. So let's find one that's going to work. I am going to start with this medium-sized one. Let's just slip that on. Hopefully, this is going to be first time, I think, just from eyeballing it, that's going to be absolutely perfect. Let's get our little guide out and we'll see how that works. I think that's going to be pretty close. Let's just try one of the thicker ones and we'll see if that is closer. Maybe too much, but that's why you've got a selection. Yeah, I think that's going to be a little too high just by looking. Although, who knows? Who knows? Probably the easiest way to tell, I think, is to tighten our strings up before we do that. So I'm going to do that now. Okay, so we've got those strings pretty close to tune. It's not in tune, but it's near enough. And now we can see, that thick shim is too thick. So we're gonna go to the next one down, which is this one. So my instincts were right to begin with. I think this is gonna be just perfect. Let's find out. Oh, that looks pretty close. Let's grab our little measurement tool and we'll find out. Yep, I think that is going to be absolutely spot on. So we're going to use this second shim. And the way we're going to do this is simply by peeling this off. We're then going to slide it under our strings, being very careful not to stick to the pickup. Slide it, not to stick to the ring rather. We're then going to slide this and stick it straight down. Straight onto our mounting plate, and that is a good, secure connection. Very, very good. Okay, so the next step is to mount the actual controller itself. And the way we're gonna do this is by mounting it on our end pin. So I'm just gonna slightly loosen the end pin, strap pin of our guitar, down there, and then I am going to grab our mounting plate. And we're going to stick that straight on there. And it's a simple case. Just snug that up ever so slightly. And then this magnetic connector there is going to stick to it. Now, that's actually going to stick using, again, the sticky dual lock stuff or the M3 stuff. You need to stop calling it dual lock. But then the magnetic part is actually on the bottom of the controller. So that sticks, which you'll see here, sticks very securely, but it also means you can remove the controller fairly easily if you so desired. So that's peeled off now, and that is gonna stick straight on here. That's secure, this is secure. Got a little cable there, but that's nothing to be concerned about, and then it's just a simple case of gently, don't over-tighten this, but gently re-tightening our strap pin, which we have there. So Fishman have also handily included this little cable retainer, which goes in your strap pin. Your included USB cable will go through this hole, and then your strap pin goes through these two, like so. And then when you connect the USB cables to the Connect little control box down here, it's just gonna slip through this tiny little opening in the rubber, and it's gonna hang down, and it's not gonna come loose if you happen to tread on it or whatever. So all told, we've managed to install our Fishman TriplePlay thus far in 8 minutes, but we can do some more fine adjustment. If we grab our little measurement tool down here, we can double check to make sure our string height is just exactly where it needs to be. Now that is super close, but with the included screwdriver, what we can also do is we can just ever so slightly increase the height. Now I think the bridge I think it's perfect here. Yeah, that's absolutely spot on. I think it's already spot on here. Yeah, that's fantastic. That is absolutely perfect on just about perfect on all of these strings. So from there, we've managed to go within 10 minutes from a guitar that had no triple play connect to a guitar with a very securely mounted but hot removable triple play connect installed. So as you can see, the installation process is really simple. It doesn't take an awful lot of time. And once you've put these attachments on, you can easily remove this pickup and then reinstall it if you so desire. Perhaps if you had a few installation points on a few different guitars, you could move the pickup from guitar to guitar depending upon what you're playing, which is really rather cool. The other thing about this, of course, is that it's a massively fun inspiration tool. It gives us the opportunity to essentially kind of live the way the other half lives, our producer and synth player friends. You can also use the app to record, and you can share the results with the world. You can save them and recall them. It's really very cool. So anyway, guys, I'm going to leave you with that there. My name is Nick Jennison for Guitar Interactive Magazine. This has been the Fishman Triple Play Connect. It's been a lot of fun showing this to you today. I will see you next time.